We are following breaking news out of Ethiopia, where a plane went down just outside the capital, killing everyone on board. Flight 302 was en route to Nairobi, Kenya, when it crashed in the town of Bishoftu just 6 minutes after takeoff. The plane was carrying 149 passengers and 8 crew members. CNN's David McKenzie is live in Johannesburg with the very latest. David, what are you learning about this crash?
Well, what we're learning, Pauline, from Ethiopian Airlines, they've just released some of the details of the passengers on this tragic flight that went down just after takeoff on Sunday morning outside of Addis Ababa. Now there are more than 30 different nationalities, a large contingent of Kenyans and Ethiopians, as you would expect, 18 Canadians, 8 Italians, 8 Chinese, 8 Americans, and then just people from all over the globe on this extremely popular route from Ethiopia to Nairobi, which is goes several times a day. The Ethiopian Airlines official saying that the pilot was a very senior pilot, had more than 8,000 hours, and had an excellent flight record, according to Ethiopian Airlines. The airline itself, Pauline, has an excellent record, but just 6 minutes after takeoff, they lost contact with ground control at Bole International Airport, going down some hours' drive or so from the capital, Addis Ababa. No survivors, tragically. There have been photographs and images released from the scene of rescuers going to the scene, but in the end, they weren't able to save everyone. It seems like that was a very heavy impact on the ground of this airline. Now, questions being asked are why, on a very good weather day, this brand new 737-800 crashed just after takeoff. Pauline?
David, the CEO did give a news conference and was answering questions. He did mention this was a very new plane, and as you mentioned, the pilot was senior. Were there any details of conversation or communications on the ground, and if there had been any problems?
No indication yet that there was any communication from the pilots to the ground of any issues that they were having. The official said that that plane originated here in Johannesburg, flying to Ethiopia, then was turned around to head back to Nairobi. There was no indication, said the official, of any problems mechanically with the plane, certainly. And this is a very busy airport, one of the busiest in Africa, and Ethiopian Airlines has a very good track record. Now, it's the exact same plane, whether it's coincidence or not, it's far too early to tell, that went then the one that went down the Indonesian Lion airplane last year. So that is something investigators will be asking, why a brand new plane has this issue twice in a short space of time. Far too early to tell if there's any connection whatsoever, but certainly there are families, both in Nairobi and in Ethiopia and around the world, that are desperately trying to find out whether their loved ones were on that plane. As I said, a very popular route for business people, UN officials and diplomats heading to and from the two East African capitals. Pauline?
Right. And the airline saying that 32 nationalities were represented. David, thank you so much. David McKenzie, live in Johannesburg.